Hi everyone, in this video I'll create the header and banner part of a website template. As this is a complete website template, I will follow a proper structure, and in future videos I will continue to build the template with many different CSS effects. Initially I have a HTML page as index.html and already included two fonts from the Google font. In the case of directory structure, I have an asset directory with CSS and images. The CSS directory contains our style sheet. Let's start creating the header structure. I'm using header tag from HTML5, which contains a div as a container. Next, add an anchor with website name. Then add a nav as main menu, which will contain the four anchors. I need another nav which will contain two anchors with icons. Here I'm using SVG icons. Template header structure is ready. Let's decorate it. Initially, I need to mention padding 0, margin 0, outline 0, and our default font in the star section to show effect on all elements. I'm declaring few color variables in the root, which will be the theme color of the template. Here, I'm adding background color on the body and anchor with a default transition effect, so that I don't have to mention the transition effect on every anchor. Next, create a container class which will be the frame of the template. As this template will be mobile responsive, that's why I'm adding a width in the percentage and max width 1100px. Come to the header part, adding background color, padding and box shadow. I'm using position sticky with top 0 to keep the header always shown on the top of the page. Then set the header container as flex to keep everything in a single line with proper distance. Adding font, color and text decoration none on the website title. One thing, link the style sheet in HTML page to show the effect. Path will be the asset, CSS, then style sheet. Now set different color on the span to make the title attractive. Come to the main menu. Here I'm using flex and gap to place all the menu in equal distance. Decorate the anchor with font, color and padding. Next, create the underline effect. For that, I'm using before pseudo element. Set width, background color and position. Initially left will be 50% and width will be 0. On hover, width will be 100% and left will be 0. Also add this effect when the anchor is active using active class. Next, decorate the icon menu. It will be display flex with a gap. Decorate the anchor with background color, width, height and border radius. Then mention the width and height of the SVG icons. To put it in the middle of the anchor, I'm using display flex with a justify content center and align item center. Change the color of the icon using path fill for the user icon and circle and line stroke for the search icon. Similarly, change the color of the both icons on hover. our header is ready. It's already responsive for big screen. Later on, I will add the mobile part. Next, come to the banner part. Here, I'm using section as a banner with a container. For the left part, I'm using a side tag with text. Image will be on the right part. You can find hundreds of vector art on webgraphics.com. I put the image on the images directory and call on image tag. Let's decorate the banner on CSS. First of all, set the background color of the banner and set container display flex to put the text and image side by side. Width of the aside and image will be 50%. Then decorate the text with font, color and margin. Next comes the animated search bar. Let's create a form as search bar with an input field and button. Button should have two SVG icons. Decorate the form. Form position will be relative with transition. Set font size, padding, border radius, transition and border on the input field. Button should be position absolute with background color and border radius, but without border. Button's display will be flexed to position the icons in the middle. Next, set SVG width and height. I already added a class on two icons respectively. Now call them on CSS to show hide them as per the condition. Initially, close icon will be hidden. For that, I'm using width height and opacity 0 and visibility hidden. Set input width to 0 and when the form is active, set calculated width and also add padding and border color. Now come to the button again. Close icon will show when the form is active. Do the same thing with search icon but in reverse. Next, create a JavaScript function to toggle the class by clicking the button. And trigger the function on click event of the button. One more thing, when the form is active, form width will change to 100%. Finally, come to the search caption. I'm using data attribute and before studio element of the form. Call the data attribute in the content of the before studio element and position it on the right side of the form. On active, width of the before studio element will be 0. There is one problem with the width string text break in line. To prevent that, I am using white space no wrap. Here is the final result. Let's check in the browser. I will continue this template in future videos. If you find this helpful, please like and comment. Let's aim for 100 likes. For more videos on web design and development, please hit the red button and subscribe to the channel.